So I do always like to start my workout on my watch to track my progress and my heart rate. And we're going to go ahead and get started. So I want you guys to spread your legs wide. We're going to reach up overhead and down to the ground. Slight bend in your knees for me. This is just getting our joints, you know, the backs of the legs, moving our shoulders, getting warmed up here. All right, we're going to release, and I want you to tap that leg back side to side here, okay? Our abs, shoulders, and our back here. You feel like this is your arms and stand, bringing them back together. So we squat down. So you can definitely grab your weights here. You can go without the weight. We're going to do a squat to a knee up, okay? So toes are facing forward, shoulder width apart. You're going to squat back, come up, knee up towards that elbow. This time you're switching legs. Now, I want you to do that chin retraction. Have your core engaged. Get your exhale. You're coming up and bringing that knee up to the elbows there. Woo. Give my arms a break. You don't have to go deep into this squat. In fact, if you feel like the squat bothers you, then you can simply just do a tap back, knee up, tap back, knee up, okay? Let's do one more squat. Knee to elbow. We're going to take it down. Now here, you're going to use the band if you have one above your knees. And if you've been with me, you've done this one before, but you don't have to have the band, okay? So the knees are bent, elbow is directly underneath the shoulder. When we come up, hips are up, we open into a clamshell here, and then lower back down. So chin retraction, get your spine straight. Oh, you go up and open. You should feel that on the backside. Make sure you're not dropping your head forward like this. So bring it back, chin retraction. Feel the abs engaged. You should also feel this in the obliques as you lift up. Last one. All right, simply rotate, swing those legs around. that elbow down, knees in front of you. We're gonna push the hips up and open the knees into that clamshell. Again, chin retraction. Breathe down into your belly. Exhale as you lift and open. Mine's at like 150 right now, but we're going to go back to that wide leg, reaching down, so toes are turned out here. We're going to lower down into that wide leg squat. You can be up higher if you need to. It's totally okay. Rotate your palm out for the hand that's going to go down towards the ground. The other one is holding up here by your ear. You lean to the side. Take that weight down. Exhale as you come up. Feel that nice good stretch as you go down. Those are the muscles that are contracting as you come back up. Make sure your lower back isn't bothering you. If it is, I want you just to come up. Last one. Woo! Got me. My arms. All right, so let's come up to standing again. We're going to do that. Wide leg squat, opening your arms and closing with your wide leg squat, okay? So get those toes turned out, but not too far that you lose your balance. You're going to have a slight bend in those elbows. I want you to open it up as you lower and come forward. Now, what's going to help you here is that chin retraction. Feel the front of your neck versus the back of your neck. The back of your neck should feel more of a stretch. But if you feel like your traps are taking over, then and just bend those elbows and bring them closer in to your chest rather than having them out there, out further. That makes it harder, okay? So this is a little bit easier. Activate your biceps a little bit more. One more. All right. Woo. Arms are going to be jello after this one. Okay, so we have that plank position where we bring that knee to the chest and lower it down to the floor. I went and grabbed a chair so I could show you this one on the chair for a couple, and then we're going to go down to the floor. So everybody join me. Plank. Okay, so this would be the down dog position. You bring that knee forward, lower it down, pick it up, and tap it back. Bring the other leg, drop the hips, lift, and take it back. Let's do a couple more like this. To the mat, and we're going to grab that band or go without it. It's totally fine. Side plank here. I want you to get that elbow directly underneath the shoulder, chin retraction, lift and open that knee and lower back down. You can do it as one fluid motion, lifting and opening the knee. Or you can come up, open, down, and back down to the floor. Whatever feels comfortable for you, sometimes breaking it down helps you to feel those muscles work a little bit more. Last one. To the other side. We're about to take a little breather. elbow underneath you. And lift those hips, open the knees. Make sure that chin is back. You can take this other hand up in the air. Heels up if you want to challenge yourself. Almost there. And bring it down. Oh, I like that one. So we're coming back up, wide leg squat, opening it up and closing. Get your position here. Whenever you lower down, you're gonna open it up. So this is the back and the backs of the shoulders, okay? So squat, open, and close. Don't let that head look forward like this, that chin coming out or dropping down towards looking to the ground, okay? Stretch, bring that knee up, drop it a little bit, and
step it back. Try to get that exhale with that knee coming forward, lowering and lifting, okay? And inhale with the down dog. Don't hold your breath.
Or no weights, it's up to you. Hold that weight here. All right, we're not pausing a lot. We're doing all six exercises, taking a breather in between. If you need to, listen to your body. You know if you need a break. Okay, but we are doing 30-minute workout, so you don't want to take long extended breaks, 1 minute max, and then get right back to it. Just long enough to get yourself a little bit of a breather. Should feel your shoulders helping you in this plank. You should feel your obliques, the side that's facing the ground. You shouldn't feel your back taking over on this, okay? So if it is, it's more of a form issue. So just make sure that your belly button is lining up with the center of your chest, okay? Sometimes we have a tendency of like leaning forward like this. One. Whew. Rotating around. Other side. Almost complete. Bring those hips forward. Push and open. Tight. watch may say I'm at 246 total calories burned. Yours may be higher, it might be lower, and it's just a gauge, right? It's just something I like to look at. I like to see, we're switching legs here, if I'm challenging myself enough, am I taking it too easy? You know, it could be that you're even on a medication that lowers your heart rate, and so your watch isn't going to register how hard your body's actually working because of that, right? Our height, our weight, our age, all of that comes into factor when the watch determines what that calorie burn actually is. So all of that, base, just find this target rate for yourself and see from the next time that you do this workout what it says and where you're at. Jot it down, make notes. Say, I did 5 pounds weight, 5 pound weights with this, and then in 2 weeks you're going to use 8 pound weights. You know, find something to track for yourself so that you can see an increase in your progress.